In this video, we will look at geometric mean. We'll start with the numeric definition and then look at geometric applications. Remember the word mean in math? We typically think of an arithmetic mean as an average. How we find the arithmetic mean of a set of numbers is we add the numbers and then divide by the number of items in the set. But in this video, we'll look at geometric mean, which is a different type of average, where we will multiply the numbers together and then take a square root. If we're talking about two numbers, if we're finding the geometric mean of three numbers, we'll multiply the three numbers together and then take the cube root. Let's start with finding the geometric mean of 2 and 18. We multiply them together to get 36. And then take the square root of 36. So the geometric mean of 2 and 18 is 6. Notice that the geometric mean is somewhere between the two numbers. It will always be numerically between the smallest and the biggest number. Now, if we wanted to think about an area model, and we had a rectangle with dimensions 18 by 2, the area of that rectangle would be 36. That would be the same area as a square of side length 6. 6 times 6 is 36. Let's think about the geometric mean of three numbers. Remember, we're going to multiply the three numbers together and then take the cube root. So the geometric mean of 10, 51.2, and 8. We multiply the three numbers and get 4,096 and then take the cube root. Notice that the geometric mean is somewhere between the smallest and the biggest number. If we wanted to make sense of this using a geometric model, we can think about a rectangular prism of dimensions 51.2, 10, and 8. If we found the volume of that prism, it would be the same as the volume of a cube of side length 16. So the geometric mean of 10, 51.2, and 8 is 16. Now let's look at an example in geometry to see how the geometric mean applies in right triangles. The directions say find the value of x in the diagram below. Please notice that the diagram shows an altitude of a right triangle. Turns out that when an altitude is dropped from a 90-degree angle in a right triangle, then three similar right triangles are formed. And I'll show you those using color coding. We have a yellow one here. We have a blue one, which I want you to imagine rotating this 90 degrees counterclockwise. And then we have the big outer right triangle. I want to rotate it and flip it so that you can imagine where we can determine that these triangles are similar. Notice in the yellow triangle, we have a height of x and a base of 7. In the blue, we have a height of 9 and a base of x. And in the green triangle, we do know that the hypotenuse is 16. Because of the segment addition postulate. I want to look at the yellow and the blue triangles, the two smaller right triangles, and I want to write a proportion that shows the height over the base. Because these triangles are similar, we know that the ratios of height over base will be equal. So I have a proportion. And in a proportion, cross products are equal. So x times x equals 9 times 7, or 63. To find x, we take the square root of 63. Unfortunately, 63 is not a perfect square. So when we take the square root, we get a decimal with a lot of digits that there's no pattern. This is an irrational number. Typically, instead of estimating an irrational number, we leave it in what we call simplified radical form. So I'd like to rewrite x equals the square root of 63 as x equals the square root of 9 times 7. Now I can take the square root of 9 out of the radical, and I get that x equals 3 radical 7, or 3 root 7, or 3 square root of 7. What I'd like you to look at is the line just above the answer. X equals the square root of 9 times 7. So turns out that altitude that was in the original right triangle is actually the geometric mean of those two segment pieces in the hypotenuse. Let's read this sentence together. The length of the altitude is the geometric mean of the two segments of the hypotenuse. And so we're going to apply this in the next example. We have another right triangle with different dimensions. We have another altitude. And we can use what we just discovered in the previous example, that x squared equals 84 times 16. I can multiply these together with a calculator, and then I can take the square root of 1,344. It is not a perfect square, so I better go back and simplify my radical. X equals the square root of 1,344. Now, I know this number is a multiple of 4, but this is going to be a kind of a pain in the neck to simplify this radical, so I'm wondering, is there a convenient way to simplify it? Well, there is. If I go back to the fact that x is the geometric mean, that means x equals the square root of 84 times 16. I know 16 is a perfect square, and 84 can be written as the product of 4 times 21. Now I can take the square root of 4 out of the radical, and I can take the square root of 16 out of the radical. So I get x equals 2 times 4 root 21. X equals 8 square root of 21. That is the length of the altitude in the right triangle. We'll not do another example, but this time the altitude is given. What's not given is one of the segment lengths. But we're going to start the same way, that 12 squared equals x times 16. This is a very convenient way to start. The altitude squared equals the product of the two segments of the hypotenuse. Now to solve for x, let's divide by 16. 12 squared is 144. 144 divided by 16 is 9. So I know that small piece of the hypotenuse is 9. The bigger segment is 16. 12 is the geometric mean of 9 and 16, which makes sense. 12 is somewhere between 9 and 16. We'll do one last example. This one looks different because I am not given the altitude, and there's one of the two pieces of the hypotenuse that's not given. So I'm going to need the altitude of this right triangle. I'll call that A. And to figure this out, let's just focus in on this little right triangle down below, which I can rotate and pull out of the diagram, and label my dimensions because my right angle is here. So my base is 36 and my hypotenuse is 60. I can use the Pythagorean theorem to determine the value of A, but all of a sudden I'm looking at this and I'm realizing, well, these numbers are kind of inconvenient. If I don't have a calculator, is there another way to solve this? So let's look again at that right triangle, wondering, is this somehow related to a 3-4-5 Pythagorean triple? What if I multiply these side lengths by 12? What would I get? I would get 36, 48, and 60. All right, so that tells me that my altitude is 48. Now that I know my altitude, I can use what we've been using in this video to solve for the unknown, that the altitude squared equals the product of the two pieces of the hypotenuse. 48 squared equals 36 times x. X equals 48 squared over 36. Once again, if I don't have access to a calculator, is there something I can do with these numbers to make them more convenient? Well, I'm noticing that between one of the 48s in the numerator and the 36 in the denominator, there's a factor of 12, so I can rewrite my fraction this way. Now I know 3 goes into 48 16 times, so I'm coming up with an answer that x equals 64. Therefore, does this answer make sense? If 48 is the geometric mean between 36 and 64, the geometric mean should be somewhere between the two. It is, it checks out. And hopefully you've learned a little bit about geometric mean in this video.